Hi there, Aquarius. Thank you so much for tuning in. Love and light to all here. You're here with your May reading. It is your overview, thematic, general reading. Let's get right to it now. Exciting energies for you, Aquarius. Oh my goodness. I was hearing for you as I was meditating on your energy before I turned on the camera. Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. I was hearing as well the song, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. There is, as I'm getting it, Aquarius, a focus on sealing a certain deal. I'm getting that it, for a number of you, may be contractual. There may be a focus on certain terms that you're laying out. You've got the Ace of Swords as well here. Mirroring Judgment, both horizontally laid. And these cards had popped out as I was meditating on your energy before I turned on the camera. The Seven of Swords, right over the Fool. Baby. This is your own card in the Major Arcana. The Father of Swords. You are super, I'm hearing, confident with whatever it is that you are laying out as terms, okay? And it's almost like there's no question of if I'm moving forward on this. Okay, very exciting. I'm hearing Sagittarius. I'm hearing Scorpio and Leo and Aries again here. There is perhaps a relationship for a number of you that is manifested. I'm hearing that is manifest. I'm hearing in a way of, excuse me, Aquarius. It's almost like there are no words. There are no words. It's a matter of, I'm hearing premonition that is unfolding. And on one hand, there is, as I'm getting it, a sort of concrete opportunity that you feel, well, I want to move in this direction. I'm hearing it feels like an opportunity, and it may be one that sort of leaves the door open for matters of the heart to sort of expand and flourish. There is perhaps a focus on relationships as well. There is, again, a concrete material side to it for a number of you, where it's like, I know for certain if I am to step along this path, I will move in this direction, perhaps professionally, perhaps in a social way, in terms of what communities I partake in, or events, community work I partake in. I know, I'm hearing for certain, that it will lead me to XYZ, that it will lead me to perhaps this individual. I'm hearing, for a number of you, take it as you will, can be taken in a number of ways. I recognize that there is, I'm hearing, an opportunity here. At the same time, there is a focus on and an acknowledgement of, I'm hearing, an appreciation of the frequency of this movement. And even if there is a material, financial, physical, professional side to it, there is at the same time an orientation towards it that cannot be, I'm hearing, experienced in a physical way. That cannot be acknowledged as, I'm hearing, holding value in the physical interface. There is a focus here on, though at the same time, it's very interesting because I'm seeing that there is a certain awakening of a potential, okay, on an energetic level, on a spiritual level, on an emotional level as well, but also in a way that is actually sort of flesh and blood, so to speak. It's like, why I'm hearing, I'm showing up, I just got the new job, I'm hearing it's a new day, I'm hearing it's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. Though, in moving in this direction, so much more I recognize. Is alluded to, is prepared for. And even if there is a physical side to it, it's not only that. Even if there's an emotional side to it, it's not only that. And you get that, Aquarius, you get that. And that is also, in a certain way, it's that feeling of, I'm hearing, I don't just want a relationship, I want it to, in a certain way, I'm hearing, carry with it, I'm hearing, a form of the unknown. I'm hearing, I want it to be unmistakable in the essence and the vibration. that it allows for us to perform through and as. And I'm getting, it's a sort of exalted feeling here, Aquarius. So beautiful, these energies. My goodness, and there's something that you're just absolutely sold on, I'm hearing, on communicating, I'm getting for a number of you, but also on conforming, I'm hearing the assets too, and it's almost like, okay, well, I'm definitely moving, okay, so I'm definitely going to prepare my stuff, I'm hearing get the boxes, again, we're getting the show on the road, okay. For a number of you, I'm hearing housework, house sitting, take it as you will. You have the Empress, the card of Aries in your apex here, mirroring Ace of Swords, very exciting energies. The Star sits upright, right over the hangs. Man, you may be dealing with a Gemini as well for a number of you, as well as a Pisces. Major overlap here with Gemini. Gemini had pulled the Star as well as the Hanged Man. Okay, and the Four of Pentacles, I believe, as well as Judgment. All right, but nonetheless, Aquarius, and you've got the card of Gemini here as well, the Lovers, right? It sits just beneath here, the Sun, that mirrors the Three of Wands. Okay, very exciting, very exciting. Take a look at this card. Portal. There is a dream for you, Aquarius, of what you want to create with your assets. And it has to do with self-perception. It has to do with how you have, perceived your own potential of creating the world that you recognize you participate in, as well on a physical level, as well in a professional way, not only in a frequential way. There is a certain material participation here, as I'm getting it, that is a focus that you recognize is a matter of, I'm hearing the incorporation of. There is, though, as I'm getting it, and there has been a certain process of awakening to, I'm hearing spiritually, energetically, also perhaps emotionally for a number of you, also in terms of how we integrate within our community, I'm hearing at work specifically for a number of you, that has brought you to the point to wish to merge in a certain way, to also appreciate, place value on the physicality of your work, of your also transformation. And it's almost like I'm hearing, I'm free. I'm hearing, 'cause I'm free. Free falling, I think that is the song. I think those are the lyrics, rather. Even if, let's say, I'm traveling. Even if, let's say, I'm nomadic. Even if I'm ghostly. I'm hearing, take it as you will. However, that may resonate with you. There is still the alluding to the boundaries of time and space through which I wish to still remain relevant as and in, that I still wish to operate through and as. There is, as I'm getting it, the utilization of what skills and talents and assets you have been bestowed with, I'm hearing, given in this state, I'm hearing, of self-expression, but I'm hearing it as well as transformation here, specifically with the Hanged Man in reverse. And it's almost like, I feel like I'm awakening. I'm hearing I'm awakening, perhaps in a spiritual, energetic way, but as well in doing that, symbiotically, there is upheld a certain recognition of what I value of the context through which I transform. And there is a performance, as I'm getting it for a number of you, be it a performance, be it a display, be it a showcasing of talent, be it a matter of communication, a decision that we feel we are to make, that we are not only to make, but that we are to make public, right? There is a certain orientation here, as I'm getting it, as it pertains to matters of community, of where it is that we stand within matters of community, and what it is that we are collectively creating, I'm hearing contributing to, by way of the decisions that we make, and by way of the decision, the orientation, the direction that we take on at this, I'm hearing juncture point, at this point in time, as we may perceive it, strength upright, smacked up in the middle between judgment and the Ace of Swords. You're feeling extremely, extremely empowered, Aquarius. In following the thread of your consciousness, that which you recognize clarifies for you where you want to move, what direction you want to move in, what you want to say, how you want to say it, what you want to communicate, and what role communication plays for you even. What is the role that writing plays for you? What is the role that I'm hearing translation plays for you? Specific message perhaps coming through for a number of you if there is a focus here specifically on channeling information and communication. There is I'm hearing focalization. I'm not sure if that's a word, but there's a focal point, okay, on what we are channeling through our communicative. I'm hearing it as explications. And there's a tremendous focus here on communication. I'm getting it as with the public. How is it that we are not only making decisions, I'm hearing, on our own, but how is it that in a certain way we are applying our decisions to what is, I'm hearing, a matter of communal participation. Okay, so there could be a focus here specifically on integration. Dear Aquarius, Son of Cups here in your theme, upright, overlaying the Hierophant in reverse, overlaying the Mother of Swords in reverse. Mother of Swords in reverse, mirroring the Son of Cups, and the Hierophant smacked up in the middle. Dear Aquarius, for a number of you, may be dealing with a Taurus, you may be dealing with an air sign and or a water sign, another air sign. Or this could be your very own energy as well. For a number of you, the feeling that I'm getting here is that there is a certain potential. I'm hearing it as a pocket of potential for creative self-expression that is capitalized on, that is brought to surface and to light by way of reorganizing our relationship to the material side to this, I'm hearing, relationship. I'm getting it as a relationship. I'm getting that for a number of you that this is another individual, and I'm getting that there may be some form of connection here between the lovers, the Three of Wands, and the Son of Cups here, okay? And the Son of Cups looks over at, right, this sort of interaction, and in fact at the whole spread. What is in a certain way being, I'm hearing cast to the side, is, and in such a way of almost, the feeling I'm getting with these three cards is almost like a parent, right, who takes their kid to school, and it's like the first day of school, and they don't want to be the one presenting their kids to the other kids. They want their kid to kind of, right, be able to present themselves in a certain way, and so there's a certain sense of surrender, okay, with, and also release with, in a certain way, as I'm getting it, also the control in a certain way, the expectation, the role also that social expectation plays in a certain way upon what is otherwise just a natural form of expression, right? Son of Cups. Inching forward, I'm hearing, making their way towards self-revelation outside of the paradigm of what is upheld as, I'm hearing, the origami, the algorithm, so to speak, of their nature. And it's, I'm hearing, it's opposite. Well, however that may resonate with you, it's opposite. I'm getting specifically here the Mother of Swords and the Son of Cups. It's, I'm hearing, perhaps, unexpected as well. And the recognition is that it must be unexpected, and that it is unexpected because what is expected. Is not what is being showcased. What is being expressed, and be it a propensity within your own right being, right? Take it as you will, Aquarius. What is being expressed is being allowed to just simply float. I'm hearing an ether for a number of you. On stage, I'm hearing on set, and it's almost like I just want to see how they waltz on stage. I just want to see how they naturally sort of take it on and make it their own, without necessarily setting any guidelines, without necessarily saying, I'm hearing we're in a relationship. I'm hearing for a number of you, I want to see how it is that they sort of communicate. And I'm getting that this is conscious, this is happening on a conscious level, be it of your own doing. Okay, it's almost like I don't want to determine whether or not they, I'm hearing, are also involved in a way that is contractually bound. I want it to sort of, it's almost like a feeling of like, let them intern. Okay, let them intern and see kind of how it is that they, what it is that they create for themselves on their own terms. Okay, thank you so much, dear Aquarius, for tuning in. Love and light to you all here in abundance as we move towards transformation. Thank you so much again for your likes, your comments, your shares, and your subscriptions. I'm so touched by all of you. Thank you for connecting. And I highly recommend you check out Rising Ascendant or Moon Sign as well. Your Venus sign may play a role additionally, specifically in matters of love, finances, and your Midhaven Angle sign may resonate with matters of career. Specifically, if you've got involvement with public in some kind of way, then their Midhaven Angle may provide further illumination there as it pertains to your public work. If you don't know your signs and you'd like to calculate them, you can do so via the link in the bio description box below, and that will calculate them for you. Let's see anything else here. I highly resonate with my moon sign in particular, right? Given that the moon is the inner being, so to speak, the sun is the outer sort of expressive component of us, so to speak, in a certain way. And of course, there are always so many factors that go into play in the birth chart. And the moon is, right, the more internal, the more yin, personal, emotional side. So depending on what it is that you want to seek insight into, then feel free to tune into those signs. Nonetheless, I'm also beckoned to mention here, for those of you who like a thorough explication of your chart, if you're interested in illumination of particular gifts, talents, abilities, and your personal blueprint, that which is related to your birth chart, astrological birth chart, I have certain services on my website that speak to exactly that. Okay, and I have readings, but I also do astrology reports, and those are about 13 pages in length, and they run through your chart, the elements that are most prominent in your chart, the archetypes that are most prominent in your chart, and how it is that they are interacting specifically with one another within the context and the framework of soul path calling. So if that's something of interest to you, feel free to check that out. I know some of you have been asking which services I provide and what I recommend. So if you've got any questions, feel free to email me at alchemyandyou@gmail.com. If you have any sort of, if you'd like insight as to which service may best suit the sort of stage that you're at and provide the greatest level of insight. Otherwise, thank you so much for tuning in. Aquarius, love and light to you all here, and I'll see you soon. Bye.